Welcome to TJD Movie Reviews, episode 54. We watched Masters of the Universe.
I'm Ty.
Jake.
And I'm Drew.
Drew, this was your pick. What the hell is this movie about?
This is based on the popular series, He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, starring Dolph Lundgren, Courtney Cox, and a bunch of other people nobody really cares about. Oh, Frank Langella. Meg Foster. There's a few people in there that people care about.
I was
going
to say, don't you dare leave out Frank.
Okay. yeah, this is basically the story of He-Man. They live in Eternia, and Skeletor, He-Man's arch nemesis, captures one of He-Man's friends, Sorceress, and plans to rule the world, and it's up to He-Man and his friends to stop them.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening.
Like you were from watching most of this film.
Yeah. It's, what is it, Gwildor?
Gwildor.
Gwildor. Gwildor.
Gwildor.
Gwildor.
Okay.
It's kind of sad that I can't remember after they said it 500 times.
So I'm pretty sure what had happened was, even before George Lucas did his Jar Jar Binks thing with Episode 1 and ruined Star Wars forever... Mattel thought it would be a great idea to create a new, mascot or, a comic relief character, in the form of Gwildor, he's like a dwarf kind of looking guy who invents things. He's a locksmith and an inventor. And they already had one, his name was Orko, and they don't really have him in this movie at all. So they instead went with Gwildor, who... they wanted to sell merch for, and they said his name a billion times in the movie. So, pro?
No. are you asking for a pro or saying Gwildor is a pro?
No, I'm asking if them saying Gwildor a million times was a pro.
I mean, it got kind of entertaining.
Did it make you want to buy Gwildor toys?
No, but it made me laugh out of sadness. Because they said it so often that it was shocking.
They, like, just randomly, too, they're just like, Gwildor.
Gwildor.
I think in any situation or scene that they could possibly use his name, they did.
Oh, Gwildor.
Yeah.
You just yell him that name. Gwildor.
I think it lost its meaning.
Pretty much.
You forgot his fucking name.
I can't believe that I still said his name wrong after they said it 500 times. Gwildor.
Like, yeah, so you're like, yeah, Goldar and
tartar sauce.
Oh, yeah.
Any pros, cons?
Well, first off, who here was a He-Man fan growing up? Like, had some of their toys or saw the cartoon or even this movie?
I was.
I saw the cartoon, but I never really cared.
I saw the cartoon. I had a few of the action figures, but I didn't know who was good or bad besides He-Man and Skeletor. So
I watched a TV show. I had the play sets. I had Castle Grayskull, and I also had Snake Mountain, the play sets. And Snake Mountain was fucking dope because they had this like thing that you could like talk into and it, like, distort your voice. It was so cool.
I'd like to play a game.
Yeah, dude, it was awesome.
I was to say, which Skeletor was it? Like the high pitched one or the low voice one?
No, you just like talking. It was like a microphone that distorted your voice, and so
you didn't sound like Skeletor.
You could if you wanted to,
dude. Gotta find that.
Oh, by the way, I wanted to give a shout out to my drummer Travis. He's like the biggest fucking He-Man fan I've ever seen in my entire life. He owns all the toys and all the collectibles and everything. In order to get this movie, I asked him if he had it. Of course he did. So thank you.
Is he a fan of this movie?
No, he fucking hates this movie. Okay. He said it raped his childhood.
That's a bold claim.
And I'm sure for some people, Power Rangers as well.
I was just going to say I have no attachment to any of these things, but I was a Power Rangers kid. God damn it.
You haven't even seen the film.
So I don't need to see it.
I at least was justified with mine because I went and saw Ghostbusters, so I could judge it.
Yeah, but you could have also not seen it and known it was going to be terrible.
Nope, I had to see it for my own. No,
you're right. I shouldn't judge a book by its cover, but sometimes you just see the cover of the book and you're like, wow, that's garbage.
So that, like, that coffee book that Madonna released called Sex.
Yeah, nobody wants to see that.
Yeah.
I'd probably open it.
Yeah, you would.
You would.
I've done worse.
Like, you've opened worse things, or...
Both.
So, pros, cons?
It's not a good movie.
No.
No, that's why we were watching bad movies for Lent.
I just... For the listener that might not know, they might be like, oh yeah, He-Man. But no, it's... This is a bad movie.
There's no Prince Adam. Is it Prince...
They don't reference Prince Adam one time. By the way, for the people that don't know He-Man or anything, Prince Adam is the form he takes when... It basically is like his human form when he's not holding the Sword of Grayskull.
When he's not hulking out.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. So, they make no reference to that. They got a lot of shit wrong. So, yeah, not great...
And say one of the pros, Frank
Langella,
yeah, as Skeletor. Even though the Skeletor costume isn't great, he at least gives a performance.
That dude was going hard.
He was.
He was the best actor.
He was all in.
He was. It was actually fun to see like an actor who's really good as him, just dive into this role.
And he didn't try the Skeletor voice. He was just like, "Fuck it, I'm going to do my own thing." And
it worked. Like I was genuinely entertained watching him. That was pretty much the only actor where I was like, yeah.
Khan, the mask, though?
Yes.
That's not his fault, though.
No.
Well, still, somebody should have been like, yeah, why don't we do something else?
Looked like a rubber condom on his face.
Yeah, or Leatherface got a hold of Bo Pelini and stapled it to Frank Langella. I'd watch that.
You'd watch. Is Frank Langella still alive?
I can check. So.
I was going to say, I can't remember if he is or not.
He appears to still be alive. He's 79 years young.
Oh, good for him. I
was going to guess he drowned in all the pussy he got from this movie.
Fuck yeah. You were Skeletor?
The likeliest of scenarios.
Let me see that bone.
I was just thinking the same exact thing.
My God. Khan. Gwildor.
Well, that goes without saying.
What is Gwildor bringing to the table? Other than he's a good locksmith?
Merchandising money.
Yeah.
Absolutely nothing.
What is he good for?
Yeah. Gwildor.
Yeah.
God damn it.
Say it again.
Yeah. Gwildor. Might be the worst thing that anyone has said on this show.
This is so dumb.
I'm glad we could take a war song and spin it into an obscure He-Man character in a movie that no one saw.
One that's not even a He-Man character. One I had to make up for this fucking movie.
I think they, broke a mold for a different toy, and they're like, we gotta fucking throw that in something.
Yeah. Why not?
Well, we were gonna soup up Orko, but, fuck Orko.
I think some of Orko would have been difficult, too, because he's, a floating little thing.
And he sounds like a child?
Yeah. Oh. The guy who did play Gwildor, though, did receive a Razzie nomination. He didn't win, but he received a nomination.
Billy Barty?
Yeah, Billy Barty.
What a great honor.
What a great name. I mean, if I knew I was having a midget child, I might... Do I want to say this? I might name it some circus freak show name.
Like Billy Barty?
Like Billy Barty, just to make his life that little extra bit
Jesus
worse.
Jesus Christ. Jeez.
And you know what? I bet he's gotten more than you ever have.
Oh, guaranteed. I'm gonna name my kid Wildor. That'd be a rough. That'd
the
be
G
a rough,
is silent.
The G is silent. It's Gwildor.
Yeah. The G is silent. I forgot his fucking name again. They say it a billion times, but it's so not important that my brain's like, you don't need that information.
Yeah, I don't
Gwildor.
Care.
Gwildor. God damn it. It's like when you're at a store and someone, like, tells you their name and you're like, okay. And then by the time you're in the parking lot, you've already forgotten that entire person.
What was his name? Wilfred?
Yeah. He was a dog?
Con? The Howard the Duck-ish, like, land on Earth type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Where are we? What is this primitive animal?
Cleveland.
Oh, no, it turns out to be worse. They're in Jersey.
Is that where they were?
Yeah.
Oh, even worse.
I won't lie to you. I thought we were watching Conan the Barbarian.
Well, they said they wanted to mix Conan with, what was it?
Howard the Duck?
No. But
they succeeded in that.
It was Conan in another film. They said that is what they were going for, was a mixture of it.
Back to the Future?
No, I don't think so.
I don't know. I could see that.
I could see it too
as well.
But yeah, this film had very little going for it.
I didn't expect them to come to Earth. I don't think
I wasn't either.
Come to Earth.
Dude, they do that in like so many fucking movies though. Like they get sidetracked. Like the whole thing with Masters of the Universe is like they're contained in Eternia. Like I didn't watch the show like a shit ton, but I had the toys and stuff and it was all contained in Eternia and they just battle it out in Eternia. I would have much rather seen them be there.
Mm-hmm.
And do shit there rather than getting sidetracked and going to Earth and doing all this stupid bullshit. But because then we have to run into Courtney Cox and her boyfriend and getting caught up in hijinks with primitive humans. That doesn't make any fucking sense in the context of this movie.
Are they vegetarians?
Yeah, I didn't get that line. That was such a stupid line.
So they're eating ribs and They find some ribs because Courtney Cox works at like a rib place and she's like, what is this food we're eating? They're like, well, I think it's an animal. And they're like, how primitive? This is barbaric. And like, what the fuck?
Yeah. So what do they eat on Eternia? Like, because bullshit. Like you said, Dolph Lundgren is not a vegetarian.
No. You don't get built like that eating fucking
tofu.
Leaves.
Yeah.
Con Dolph Lundgren.
Oh, gosh.
He looks the part.
Oh yeah,
I'll give him credit. He's He-Man.
Everything else though, nah.
He can't act worth shit in this film.
His delivery is among the worst. It's Stallone-esque delivery there.
Except at least Stallone can speak English.
Can he though?
However mumbled it is, at least it's English.
I mean, we were making Stallone jokes when we heard him say his first fucking lines in this movie.
Hey there, Wildor. Wildor Sockbat.
What?
That's a show nobody remembers. Except Drew, I guess. Drawn Together.
Oh, yeah. I remember Drawn Together. God, that was a funny show. She had the monster in her
Octopus
vagina.
Octopuswa. We made reference to this before on the pod.
Okay.
We are classy individuals.
Yeah.
Oh, we're classy whores.
Dolph Lundgren sucks.
I think Stallone probably would have done better.
As He-Man?
Yeah.
Yeah, but
he would have been fucking weird looking. With that stroke looking face.
Jeez.
Like a bowl of melted ice cream. But,
do you think Arnold would have been better?
Arnold?
Yeah, Arnold.
Oh, he would have looked the part.
He probably would have wanted too much money for this, though.
Was Arnold, well, 87, yeah.
Yeah,
I think
Predator had already been out, and so maybe even Total Recall.
Had he done Conan, then?
Yeah, he had done Conan.
I don't think you can do Conan and He-Man. That'd be like a... You're blurring... You're crossing the streams.
You say that, but Ryan Reynolds has done Green Lantern and...
Deadpool
and Blade, yeah. So,
and one of these was much more well received than the others. Green Lantern.
I don't hate Trinity either. There is some bad acting in it, but I don't hate Trinity.
I don't know. Ryan Reynolds is one of those. He's the box office kiss of death for whatever reason. For everything except Deadpool.
Mm-hmm.
But that Life movie did not do well.
No. But what about X-Men Origins Wolverine? That did pretty well. It wasn't a good film, but it did well at the box office.
Yeah. I don't know. Sometimes you look back at the numbers and you're like, how in the fuck did this make that much money?
Or Safe House. Safe House made a shit ton of money.
Is that the Denzel one?
Mm-hmm.
I never saw it.
It was okay. I mean, you had two very charismatic leads with Denzel and Ryan, so.
That helps.
Yeah.
How do we feel about Courtney Cox?
I mean, she looks exactly like Courtney Cox. Well, a younger version of Courtney Cox with shoulder length hair instead of like down her back, but I'm just saying, like, it's her with a different hairstyle than you used to seeing her with.
Right.
Yeah.
That was a level of detail that I didn't think we needed to go into.
I'm just trying to paint a word picture for our listeners.
I mean, they would have guessed, oh yeah, 87, she would have looked probably a little different.
Hey, some people keep their hair the same. Like, Nicole Kidman, have you seen it different? I mean, it's always that long blonde
hair. I don't keep track of celebrities' hairstyles.
I don't even know what to say to you.
Okay, whatever, fine.
Do you have a photo collage of just a bunch of famous people on, like, the roof of your apartment?
On the roof of my apartment? You mean the ceiling?
Yeah, the ceiling. Yeah, you take the stairs up to the roof, and you look down on the pictures.
So no one else can see them. Yeah,
and the weather has stripped half of them off. Yeah, that'd be stupid, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Probably don't do that.
No, I go on Google Maps and like I zoom in so that when I'm at work I can look at them whenever I want to.
Or you can just take a picture of them all.
No, too easy.
Okay.
What a complex life.
Short and sweet, Courtney Cox is hot.
Yeah.
How do you feel about her acting in this movie?
Courtney Cox level-esque. I'm not a huge, like, I don't think she's a bad actress. I'm just not a huge fan either. So.
I thought it was passable.
She's fine.
Yeah.
Nothing special.
No. Like,
there was nothing in the movie where you were like, oh shit, Courtney Cox, but, you know, she's not pulling a Frank Langella.
No. No. Nobody is in this movie.
But she's better than Dolph Lundgren.
I would agree. Her delivery is much better than Dolph's.
I think Gwildor was better than Dolph Lundgren.
Gwildor!
Gwildor!
Is a G. There's a G-W.
Gwildor.
Gwildor. Yes.
Dude, I can't remember that name. Like, I've deemed it so not important to my life. Like, I've already looked into the future, and I'm like, I don't need to know that.
Then watch you at, like, movie trivia night.
Yeah. Or he's on Jeopardy or something. What was the name of the thing in Masters of the Universe?
Then you're going to hear it bleeped because I'm going to be like, fuck.
He goes, what is a Wildor?
Trebek will just be like, fuck.
The G is silent.
You can't say that on television.
Piece of shit, mother...
Yeah, I get fined by the FCC. I end up losing money after winning Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I won the game, but I owe $130,000 because I yelled fuck during Final Jeopardy.
Because of one stupid character in this stupid film.
I would find that actor and murder him.
Well, I think Billy Barty is dead.
Well,
I think. Check.
Dig him up and punch his decayed corpse in the face.
Billy Barty.
Is it? Because
He's dead. He died in 2000.
Wow. Yeah, that would probably be a skeleton now, and so he's...
Skeletor?
I was going to say he's
the new Skeletor?
He's Gwildor.
he was in Willow.
That doesn't surprise me. No, I mean, Willow has a big cast of...
short people?
Yeah.
Got no reason?
Oh my gosh, we're not going into Randy Newman.
Fuck you. Oh my god.
That is a terrible song.
Short people got no reason.
Copyright strike.
I hope I don't sound like Randy Newman. You got a friend in me.
You sound like...
You got a friend in me. You
sound like Will Sasso as Randy Newman.
Oh, that's even more hurtful. No one's seen Will Sasso in ages.
Last thing I saw him on was How I Met Your Mother. He played a bartender.
Oh, boy. That's big for him.
He's supposed to be in something here pretty soon.
Will Sasso. Wait, you're keeping up on Will Sasso's filmography?
No, I heard his name mentioned not too long ago.
Just now?
No, it was for something else. God damn it. Oh, Super Troopers 2. I heard Jay Chandrasekhar talking about him. So yeah, he's going to be in that.
Yeah, the film's been like in production for, what, 2 years?
Yeah, I wouldn't hold my breath for that, guys.
It's not going to be as good as they hope.
Probably not, but...
Be better than Joe Dirt 2.
Yes.
I hope.
Oh, God, yeah.
That movie, that was awful.
Why didn't we pick that? I should have picked that.
Because we've seen it.
I haven't seen it.
I know you haven't seen it.
I'm sure I would be horrified by
it. I really don't want to see it again. There was like one part I laughed at, and that was it.
It's got to be better than Yoga Hosers.
Are you talking about the Thug Life part?
Yes.
Yeah, that's the best part of the movie for sure.
And it would rival. It just, you randomly have a Christopher Walken show up in it, and you're like, okay, I guess this makes the film, like, this scene passable, but...
Nah, the movie sucks.
It does.
There's nothing really redeemable about that one. So, Masters of the Universe.
Yeah, we have
more pros, more cons.
Pro, when He-Man starts using his sword at the beginning, the sparks flying off the guys.
Mm-hmm. Through the combat, yeah.
I thought it was pretty cool. I mean, I didn't know they were robots.
Put
two and two together.
They don't preface that beforehand.
So, with the creation of this film, Mattel had the rights to say what could be used, or how He-Man could be used. And one of their things was that he could not be shown killing anyone on screen. So, they made all the henchmen be dressed up in these black... Stormtrooper-esque outfits, and they were robots, but they just don't say they're robots, but because of the sparks flying and everything, they're supposed to be, like, it's supposed to be known that they're robots, because those are the only people he kills.
I liked Evelyn.
You mean Evelyn?
Evelyn.
No, it's Evelyn.
Meg Foster.
Sure. Yeah, is that who plays her?
I believe it's Meg Foster, yep.
That was doing it for me. Don't know why.
What was...
I don't know.
Her outfit?
Like, yeah, the outfit.
As I say, I had that action figure, Evelyn, that action figure.
Yeah, except she was yellow. Her action figure was yellow.
Yeah.
Oh, that meant she was Haitian.
No. No.
Like, wow, Drew. Would have been a good toy, except it was yellow.
I never said that. Hey man, I love The Simpsons.
I know. I just took it
totally wrong.
Took it the wrong way. A Mickey Rooney action figure.
Jeez.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, she was doing it for me. I don't know why.
Was it the blue eyes?
The eyes are nice. Mm-hmm. Or it could have been that you told me that the suit made her suffer throughout the entire shoot.
Gave her a bruise on her groin.
Yeah.
Jake's like, I'll give her a bruise on her groin. You might want to cut that.
I mean, you're not wrong. That might be it.
As he screams, I have the power!
Do you think anyone has ever yelled that during sex? It's got to be guaranteed, right?
Just like
ask Travis. Because if he hasn't done it, I'm disappointed.
He probably has.
I mean, I'm sure somebody did, like, after that Boom Goes the Dynamite thing, somebody, you know, did that.
But they had to scream it, like, at the top of their lungs.
The whole neighborhood could hear it.
Oh
yeah, that's great.
I mean, it's just like people playing I Just Had Sex by Lonely Island right after it.
Do people do that?
I would be surprised if somebody's done that.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. I've never done it, but To each their own, I guess. So this movie was directed by a dude named Gary Goddard. His first movie ever was He-Man. And his last.
Oh.
He directed some shorts for, like, theme park rides.
Oh!
So, like, Jurassic Park The Ride.
Oh.
And I think he wrote for another... He wrote for a Terminator ride, I think. He wrote one of the scripts or something for one of those. But, yeah, this dude only did one film.
Hmm.
At least... And he did a good job?
No.
Well, you were saying earlier that this movie was kind of in, like, production hell.
Oh, yeah. But this film, because Canon Films was a smaller studio, but they had some big rights. Like, they had Spider-Man rights, they had Superman rights, they had He-Man rights. And instead of doing a Spider-Man film that they had planned, they decided to drop that, spend the money on Superman 4, The Quest for Peace, which is a dog shit movie, and He-Man. And they ended up hemorrhaging money because Superman didn't make shit. And then this film was just going over budget, and that they actually shut production down for a couple months before they could film the finale. So, before they were able to get enough money back to film the finale for this. And then you can obviously tell that, like, the set just does not look right at all. Like, they turned it into nothing but, like, lights in the background, yeah. And everything's dark.
It's bare bones.
There's, like, a red and blue light that flashes. Mm, yeah. Then he throws Darth Maul down the hole.
Emperor Palpatine?
Yeah.
Or, oh, wait, you mean Skeletor.
Mm.
Gwildor.
Gwildor. Yeah. They copied that from Star Wars. But what you don't get in Star Wars is a stinger scene.
It was a pretty great stinger. in the sense that you could tell that it was filmed in a time span of like 5 minutes.
Literally, it was one take. They had him in the water. All he was supposed to do was come out and say, "I'll be back." And then that was it.
Yeah.
So they said, "Action." He did it. They said, "Okay, we're done."
Frank Langella, you only need one take for him every time. Mm-hmm. He gives you perfect shit every time. One thing I'm surprised about, though, is that this Gary Goddard guy would take Dolph Lundgren's takes and be like, "Yeah, that delivery was great, Dolph. Like, we don't need to go reshoot that again. Or, hey, maybe try it with a little bit more emotion."
Here's the thing.
Or any.
Yeah.
What happened was he originally planned to have him dubbed over. But because they started running behind because of all the financial issues, he didn't get to.
They could have gotten, like, anybody to, like, just run the entire flick, give them the lines when they're supposed to do the lines. They could have brought in a homeless guy who could have put more emotion into this than Dolph Lundgren did.
Well, you got to get money to go to the recording studio.
Well, the other thing was Lundgren in his contract had first rights to redub his lines, and he had like three attempts or something like that. Or he got three different studio sessions to try and redub them. So
it was shit.
Well, they totally gave him every chance, but they ran so far behind they didn't even have a chance to let him try, so.
It's a shame. I mean, not like the movie would have been like a bajillion Oscar times worthy. Better, yeah.
We'd all have tears in our eyes.
Oh, Dolph.
I never knew you could act.
I mean, if you've seen The Expendables with him in it, you know what you're getting.
Yeah, pretty much.
I don't know, Showdown in Little Tokyo is pretty good.
I never saw Showdown. That's the one with Brandon Lee, right?
Yeah, that movie sucks. It's a bad movie. It's good for everything except him. Shang Tsung is in that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, OG Shang Tsung.
Hmm.
He's in the Yakuza. Shocker. He was in the Yakuza in, like, every movie he was ever in. Except Mortal Kombat.
That you know of.
Well, yeah, was Mortal Kombat tied to the Yakuza?
Could not tell you.
He's from the Outworld Yakuza.
I was going to say, did Outworld have a Yakuza?
Yeah.
They're probably into some really scary shit then.
Yeah.
Like flaying and eating people.
They steal planets and
they
shit.
Do animalities to each other.
Mm.
And steal Brings souls.
A, so that's... I just realized that's why they didn't call it bestiality, huh? Because that would be a different game.
Yes.
And then Howard the Duck shows up.
See Scorpion just drop his pants and start fucking a penguin or something. Well, I guess Sub-Zero would fuck a penguin, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Scorpion would fuck a, what, Venus flytrap?
No, he's
Wait,
all
that's
about
not
that
an
fire.
Animal.
Yeah. No, that's not an animal.
That's a plant, Jake.
Yeah. I'm trying to tie something to what they do, though.
A dragon?
Like, okay, maybe a dragon. Yeah.
No, but that's Liu Kang.
Is that a real... A Komodo dragon?
Something that breathes fire. Something with fire.
Komodo dragons don't breathe fire. Plus, if you try to fuck a Komodo dragon, you're gonna get your shit rocked.
Have you tried?
No.
No! How would you know?
Yeah. That'd be a hell of a security...
We need
security,
you know,
footage for Henry Dorley to have.
We need a segment on this show that's called Sex Tips from Jake.
No, we don't need
because
that.
Because it consistently happens every week. Like, stay away from furries, or...
Don't fuck Komodo dragons. I mean, it should be common sense. They're literally dinosaurs.
If you played Far Cry 3, you know a Komodo dragon can fuck you up.
I feel like our listeners come to this for your sex advice. I really do.
That's highly unfortunate.
See, what sucks is I had a joke all lined up, too, and Jake took it away with his bestiality joke, because it's going to be like, those animalities, they bring a new new meaning to the word furry.
Mm.
But, yeah, Jake fucked it up.
Yeah. I wonder what Kano would fuck.
A cannonball. Because he turns into one.
But a cannonball's not an animal.
No.
Not with that attitude.
What? Why Kano would fuck to begin with?
I broke him.
I will break you.
I don't understand. Drew, no matter how hard I wanted it, a cannonball is not an animal.
You just gotta drill some holes and put some googly eyes on it.
That's all that an animal is.
It'd be an armadillo, because they can roll up into a ball.
Yeah, sure.
Is that better?
Yeah, sure. I don't know what the fuck just happened.
I don't know why we're discussing what animal a Mortal Kombat character we have sex with to begin with.
Well, now I know that Drew considers a cannonball with drilled holes and googly eyes an animal.
Is that just a bowling ball?
Yeah. I mean, if you add lube, anything is possible.
Oh my god.
Some anyway. More pros, cons.
The police detective in this, he was awful. Yeah, I think, and what sucks is he was in Back to the Future as the principal. I don't remember the principal's name, but he appears in all three of them, I think. He's in the first one and the third one, I know for sure. I don't remember if he shows up. Yeah, he shows up in the second one, just in bits parts. Yeah, because he has to steal the book out of his...
Oh, the sports almanac?
Yeah, out of the principal's office. And it turns out to be the Ooh La La magazine. But, yeah, he's good in those films. But this one, I don't know. I think he was just there for the paycheck. He was just like, what the hell? Whatever.
I also don't buy him staying there at
no.
all.
No.
No. You seem like too committed to be like, oh, like you kids are going to jail and blah, 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 and
I've been to Korea.
Yeah. He was just, I don't know. It was just like a half-assed, like, performance.
Yeah.
I didn't buy it.
Now I get to stay here. I get this woman. What a retirement.
And the girl's like, wait, what?
Yeah. She's like, I'm just, you know, standing here. I didn't agree to this.
Honestly, I don't even think that part was needed.
No.
Really.
Con, the sequel setup.
Yeah. That was a bold play.
You're just talking about the stinger?
No, well, not the... The stinger's funny. I'm saying, like... The stinger helps set it up, but, like, they're talking about how they can always come back to Eternia. So, obviously, like, you know, kind of like the Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe or whatever, those Narnia films where they always leave something where, like, then they can get back to them.
Mm. So. Courtney Cox pawns the little trinket they gave him. Like, I'm never going back to that fucking place.
Pro, the moment where we thought that there was a huge plot hole in this movie.
With Carl and Kevin?
No.
No!
I mean, that was pretty cool, but... No, I mean, when they're sending him back and they say, just send me back to the time that we left.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to preface the listener. Courtney Cox's parents die.
No, yeah. They don't need to know that.
Yeah, they do.
I know. Yes, they die in a plane crash. She was supposed to go with her parents to the beach. Instead, she blows them off to go meet with Kevin, to blow him off. And then they instead go to Catalina on an airplane that her father was flying, and they crash and die. So she's going to leave town. She's going to leave Jersey and go 3,000 miles away.
Fucking Catalina wine mixer.
Fucking Catalina wine mixer.
All right.
But, yeah, so, like, as... So at the end, Gwildor is like, I could send you anywhere. Past, future, just name it. Mm-hmm. And they're like, just send us to when we left.
Yeah. They're like, nah, I'm good.
And I'm like, why the fuck wouldn't you go back to your parents? But then as she's walking into the time circle thing,
she's like, oh, fuck! Wait!
Wait, no! And Kevin's just like, come on! And it's like, wow, alright. It's not a good relationship.
Forget about your dead parents.
I'm your parents now.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Better movie.
Oh. But, yeah. And so it happens he does send her back to... Which I was wondering if that would actually, like, create, like, a Back to the Future thing where she would be existing twice at one time. Hmm. But no, they made it so she just is sent back to her body at that moment.
So you'd have to find your clone and smother it?
Yep. You have to murder it.
You think you could kill yourself? A clone of yourself.
It's like, no.
I mean, yeah. It's the thought that keeps me sane, the fact that I could kill myself.
The clone,
you know,
or...
No, just hosers. Me. It's comforting.
Mm.
Whenever the odds are too high in someone else's favor, I'm making it sound like, yeah, anytime I'm going to lose, I'm like, I'll just fucking kill myself. That's not what I'm saying.
Just stop. Just stop.
This is a strange tangent you've chosen to go on.
I think I'm done. We're going to leave that one. Because I don't know where,
where you were going.
There's no final destination. Speaking of final destination. Yeah, that's what I kind of hoped was going to happen with this.
Oh, that she would have to go with her parents, like, on the plane?
Or like, oh, you saved them, but they were destined to die anyway.
Mm.
So, like, they walk out and get the mail, and a drunk driver hits her dad at the mailbox.
And Devin Sawa pops out, and he's like, no!
Oh, shit.
And then her mom runs out, and then the drunk driver backs up over her.
Yeah.
To Mambo music.
Yep.
Blood Diner's a great movie.
That bitch died of a heart attack.
But no, I also thought... They gave that trinket to Courtney Cox, but then at the end, Kevin is holding it.
Yeah, Kevin steals. Didn't you know that? I mean, he stole that keyboard from that instrument store. And
He also stole that...
stole that giant, that teleportation device.
Yeah.
Like, he steals shit.
I mean, he goes into her house that they're selling.
Yeah.
And he just steals food out of the fridge.
This movie should be called Kevin is a Dick.
It doesn't have the same ring.
Oh.
He-Man and Kevin is a Dick.
Yeah. Although I'd be very interested. Like, if I was on Fandango going through movies coming out, I'd just see Kevin is a Dick. I'd be like, what the fuck is that all about?
So you saw John Tucker Must Die then?
No.
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 What about John Dies at the End?
No. Wow, there's a lot of movies with Johns that die.
I never saw John dies at the end. Is it any good?
I haven't seen it either.
Oh. Does he die at the end?
Probably.
Oh, okay.
He hasn't seen it.
Oh. I'm just asking.
I assume that he does.
Yeah.
He may have wikied it.
If not, it's false advertising.
Yeah. Maybe that's the twist.
Yeah.
It's another guy named John.
We've taken this to a weird place.
Yeah, well, it happens.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, I mean, do we expect any less? But this film, product placement.
Why?
I don't know, I just found it fun. Like, the old Burger King he's thrown away in her house. The Pepsi cans that just happen to be backstage at this prom setup. It's like, why? What else was there? Lazy Boy. Like a Lazy Boy box. But not the actual, like, chair or anything. Just a box that says Lazy Boy on it. Well,
they probably filmed it in a Lazy Boy warehouse.
Probably.
So you were entertained?
By the
product placement?
Yeah. I was like, they actually paid money to be in this film.
That's an odd pro.
It is.
I wouldn't call that a pro.
I would.
I just thought it was funny. Because it made me...
It's like, ooh, Burger King.
Well, it made me reminisce about how good Burger King used to be, and now it's a piece of shit.
Careful there. We don't want to lose another sponsor.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so hungry I could eat at Arby's.
Man, I love Burger King. Those wonderful chicken fries and tender crisps.
And those mac and cheese filled Cheeto Bites.
Yeah, that was a mistake.
Those are good. You shut your whore mouth.
My whore mouth?
Yeah.
You actually had the mac and cheese chicken fries?
Yeah, they're good.
They're good?
Yeah.
I would have thought for sure that was horrifying.
Dude, they're good.
I miss their Angus Whopper burgers. They don't have those anymore.
We're actually going to talk about Burger King.
No, we're not going to talk about
we're
this.
We're doing it. We're there.
I will say, I wish McDonald's had onion rings.
Does anybody have a gun?
Nope.
Why do we need a gun?
So I can shoot myself.
Oh, any more pros, cons with this?
I'll give a pro. I genuinely enjoyed some of the sets, the Eternia sets, like the giant chamber for...
that they spent way too much money on?
Yeah, it looked awesome though, didn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it looked like a giant ass chamber in a Grayskull castle, whatever that's supposed to look like, it looked like it.
Yeah, I thought it was genuinely cool.
But along with that, I'm going to say a con, because every time they used that fucking, like, projector thing where he spoke to all of Eternia, it was the same fucking scene, like, there were hostages on a cliff. And that was the same thing every time he spoke out of that. I'm like, oh, so that's all of Eternia? What the fuck?
It seemed like there was, like, four people out there.
Yeah. It's like, they're fighting for a planet of four people.
It looked like Zordon outside of his tube, and he just would yell at four people randomly, and they just stood there like, all right.
Because when they do, like, a shot out of Grayskull, it's Grayskull, right?
Snake Mountain.
Whatever. No, I think Snake Mountain's different than Grayskull.
Snake Mountain is where Skeletor is from. Castle Grayskull is where He-Man resides.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is when they zoom out of Grayskull, you see a giant cityscape. It's like, why don't we see more of that? Why do we have to go to Earth and not just keep this in this realm?
Because budget. That's exactly why.
Cheaper to film it behind the director's house.
That's why they took it to Earth, because they're like, well, we spent a shit ton of money on the fucking chamber, and let's go film some real places because we ran out of money.
Yeah, pretty much. I guess that sounds right.
Yeah. Con. No Skeletor voice.
God, that would be... But you couldn't take this film seriously.
Yeah, you totally couldn't.
I mean, how would I take it seriously to begin with?
I mean, at least they were trying.
I want to hear Ty's Skeletor impression.
I have balls. My voice doesn't go up that high.
Well, I don't have any, apparently. See, one of them just sucked up inside me.
Shy ball syndrome?
Yeah. That'd be more Mickey. And I'm not doing that, because I know Disney will sue us.
Do we want to do scenes?
We could, if you want to. I don't know what... I mean, I guess there are enough scenes here, but... Yeah, if you have one in mind, Drew, go ahead.
I mean, it's nothing spectacular. It was just a scene that was... I was just like, yeah! Like, the kid inside of me, it was just chanting. It's the scene where He-Man pulls the sword out from where Skeletor had it stashed, and he screams for the first time in the movie, "I have the power!" And I was like, yeah, this is dope as fuck. And then he started to wreck Skeletor. It was awesome.
I don't know if wreck Skeletor is the right thing.
Oh, it's right.
He gave him a new meaning of skull him. Fucking.
I'm so hard right now.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't like...
Ow!
It was like a super amazing scene, but just that part where he lifts the sword up and there's like this big moment. He finally says it. Iconic of the TV show and everything. The kid inside you screams because it's sweet.
The kid inside me screamed, change the channel. Maybe Jabberjaw's on.
Or Kung Fu Fooey.
Hong Kong Fooey.
There we go.
He always says it wrong.
Kung Fu Fooey, Gwildor. Jesus Christ.
Nope, he wasn't in this.
God, you love that joke.
I do.
Never gets old, does it?
Nope.
Nah, it's always been old. It's a bad joke.
In your mind.
Okay.
We're going to put you in the well.
We'll do a poll. Like, I'll ask the listeners. I'm not going to poll anybody. All right. So my scene, the one I enjoyed the most, I guess.
Sure. If you want, sure.
So Courtney Cox looks out a random window and sees Evelyn as her mother, and... I mean, we already said her mom died in a plane crash, but for whatever reason, Courtney Cox is like, oh shit, mom's out there. Well, she doesn't say that.
Oh shit, guys, it's mom.
Oh shit, son.
Flavor. No, that didn't happen. But no, she looks out the window and she's like, oh, mom's out there. And yeah, she goes up this alleyway and she's like, oh... I'm your mother. Wait, did she actually say anything like that?
Yeah, she's like...
Hey, honey, blah, blah,
yeah,
blah.
Yeah, me and your dad are actually safe.
You've been hiding out or something like that.
Yeah, we're doing a secret project.
Mm-hmm.
They talk to her like she's a fucking, like, 8-year-old that's going to be like, oh, okay. But, yeah, they're like, your friends... Well, actually, she does it, so I guess she is as stupid as a Labrador or whatever. But yeah, she's like, your friends have something that I need. It's a shiny thing that makes shitty light shows, and can you bring it to me? And she's like, yeah, mom, I'll do that. So she goes and gets it and brings it to her, and the best part is after she gives it to her, she just turns back into Evelyn, and Courtney Cox screams, like, so over the top that you're actually like, what the fuck? Like, you're taken aback by it. Like, just a, no! And you're like, what?
Like Luke when he finds out that Vader's his father.
Yeah.
It looked like she was back on the Scream set and saw the Scream Killer.
Yeah,
Does she make it through all four of those films?
She makes it through the first.
I know she's... At least she makes it to the fourth one. I don't know what happens to her in the fourth one.
I thought eventually she did die.
Oh.
Spoiler for Scream, I guess.
Does anybody really care about Scream 4?
It's been out for fucking ever.
Yeah, I suppose. But, yeah, I just thought that was funny that really out of the usual reaction. And then later, somebody else did it when the key... Evelyn did it when the key was taken from her. She had, like, a crazy, over-the-top reaction, and I don't know,
Oh, that was when He-Man stole it.
Yeah, and she, like, flipped the fuck out, too. And you're like, wow, they really like that key.
I mean, that thing is awesome, dude. You can transport it anywhere in time and unlock anything you want.
In the universe.
Yeah.
And he could take it to a pawn shop twice for no reason.
It wasn't a pawn shop. It was a music store.
Yeah. Oh.
For no reason?
Yeah. Well, he thought he might know what it is. Because, like, they thought it was a Japanese synthesizer.
Well, like, when the dude was like, I've never seen anything like this before. Do you want to sell it? And he's like, no, I just came down here to, you know, talk shit and show it to you.
Well, he asks if, he's like, have you seen this before? He goes, yeah, I've seen it before. And then he does something. He's like, oh, shit. And he's like, oh, so you've seen it before. He at least threw it back in his face. So. So he's like, no, I don't want to sell it. I just wanted to see if you had any information on it. So.
What's your scene, Ty?
It's a shitty scene.
Sweet.
And Jake kind of mentioned it. But Dolph Lundgren ends up riding, like, he's fighting the forces of Skeletor, who has now come to Earth with, like, this huge army. And he ends up on this, like, flying skateboard, hoverboard, circle thing. And it's just shit.
Dude, it was awesome.
I mean, he's shooting guys off of theirs or swinging his sword and killing them. And but, like, it's just... When you see him, it's just like a stiff thing going across the screen. He's not moving or anything. Oh, it's, the way it was superimposed just looked like complete...
Dog shit.
Utter crap. Yeah. It was... It is not... Like, it's funny to laugh at, but it is a terrible, terrible scene. And it's like, well, obviously they wasted their money on everything else instead of him... actually, like, doing any true stunts or anything. Or using wires to be on this. They just... They photographed him on one, and then they just used that.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. I got another con. This is the most I've ever seen He-Man use guns, ever.
I didn't even know He-Man was a universe that had guns.
Yeah, they had guns because you got Man-at-Arms. Like, that's literally the definition of his character. But...
He was capping people.
But, like, yeah, He-Man wields a sword. Like, that's what he does.
I was going to say, why is He-Man bringing a sword to a gunfight?
Because it's fucking sweet sword. Chop bitches down with that thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
Or just get shot in the face.
Yeah, exactly.
No, he flicks it back. I don't know.
It's not a fucking lightsaber.
I mean, he kind of acted like it was
in this movie. Yeah, he does, but it's not. It's a fucking steel
or it's a sword.
Sword.
But it's the sword.
Mm.
No. Yeah, that's a con to me. It's the way they use a sword mixed with all these guns. I'm sorry, if that's actually in the comics and that shit, I don't... That's weird to me.
As far as I know, I don't remember from, like, the cartoons where he ever used a gun.
Yeah. I just don't think a gun works very well in this sense. Like, a cannon? Sure. Okay, somebody has a cannon. But a straight-on laser gun, like... 20 guys with a laser gun and one guy with a sword. He's screwed.
Mm-hmm.
Or he should be, but no. Like,
get your logic out of here, Ty.
Like that fight he had once he broke away at the end. And he just lazily throws the one guy into a group of them.
He's just pushing people around on a set.
It wasn't even like a fight. It was just like, oh.
Which supposedly, like, because you don't see what happens to him, but that Blade thug or whatever, one of the main villain assassins, Blade, is supposed to have also fallen into the pit. You just see him kind of get hit, and that's the last you see of him. And
Wesley Snipes?
Yeah. Yes. Wesley Snipes. Better movie. He-Man's a vampire. Wesley Snipes has to stop him.
Yeah, that's a better movie. I'd watch that.
This fucking He-Man always trying to ice skate uphill. Lines that would never be written in a movie. Well, I don't know. Some of the shit we've seen wouldn't be shocked anymore. What the hell is Skeletor? Is he just a skeleton?
No, he's, oh, God. If Travis was here, he could fucking tell you.
Is he like a man body with a skeleton face? I think he's
actually, like, human.
Yeah, he's human with, like, a skeleton face, but, or head.
Let me wiki him real quick.
Because there is an answer to this.
Jake, have you seen the Masters of the Universe parody porn?
No.
Oh, I'm just asking.
Is that real?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh, so you don't even know if it's
real. I don't
real.
Know if it's real.
Rule 34.
I'm sure Jake is going to look now.
We'll get to the bottom. That's got to be something there for He-Man. But I'm interested in Skeletor. Let's see how creative these sick fucks get.
Jeez.
Anyway, sick fucks. I call them sick fucks as I'm looking for it.
He was once a man whose face was accidentally splashed with a corrosive liquid. He survived, but at the cost of his face.
Huh.
Yeah. I was gonna say, like, everything I've seen, like, all everything looks like he has muscle and skin, just he's blue, but, yeah. Well,
he's pretty buff for a skeleton.
Yeah, so, like, but, yeah, just his face has been corroded. He's kind of like Two-Face, but a skeleton instead of just being horribly disfigured.
Mm-hmm. Dude, there's gotta be some great Skeletor shit.
Oh my god.
I don't know. I don't even want any part of this.
Oh, you're going to see.
He's going to make you see.
You're coming down the rabbit hole with me.
This film wasn't very well received by critics, though. I think on Rotten Tomatoes right now, it stands at 17%. 40% user reviews. And then, but on IMDb, it has like a 5.3. Which
That's
is
way too high.
Way too high.
Like, way too high.
And then, also, supposedly, on the last day of filming, they asked Dolph Lundgren if he was going to do the sequel, and he said, hell no. So, they had to start looking, because they had a sequel written. It was called Masters of the Universe 2, Cyborg.
What?
That sounds like a bad idea.
But this film, which was made for $22 million, only brought in $17 million, and then Canon Films went under, so the sequel was scrapped.
I mean, rightly so.
Jake, I'm kind of worried how much you're scrolling on your phone.
I'm trying to find Skeletor.
My god.
Dude, we might have found some porn that doesn't exist.
Well, you can always make it. That's a great thing about the internet.
My life was just given purpose.
Just now?
Yeah. Oh, no, there's Skeletor.
I'll give you my bone, He-Man.
Oh, no, it's He-Man and Skeletor. Not going to show you that one.
So,
you would think less of He-Man.
So, Ty, I heard... What did you have for budget information for this movie?
22.
22 mil?
Mm-hmm.
And what did it make back?
17.
So lost 5 mil.
Yep.
Ouch.
Yeah.
What else did you say that that Canon Films did that lost them?
That's unexpected, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, I didn't need to see that.
Yeah, you did.
You had a... There were a couple other films.
Oh, it was Superman IV, The Quest for Peace, which... That film made nothing on its budget, because I was bored one day and actually looked up all the Superman films to see how they did, and that one was, like, very, very poorly received.
So... what the fuck?
Oh my god!
I like how, like, shitty it is. Like, some little fucking pissed off 10-year-old was like, fuck Skeletor. I'm gonna fuck him right in his eye socket.
Quest for Peace was made for $17 million and made $15.7 back.
Basically, this Canon film shot their wad and went out of business because
Canon made it till 1994, but let me look at some of their other films that were around 1987.
Oh no,
it's probably not great. Whatever it is,
let's see. They did Highlander. They did the original Highlander.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Didn't that make money?
Yeah.
I think so.
They did that Cobra film that...
Stallone?
Yep.
People love that movie.
Oh, Frank Langella actually enjoyed his role as Skeletor. Dolph Lundgren hated being He-Man.
Well, Dolph Lundgren didn't put anything into being He-Man, so...
He could barely speak English. I mean, this was just barely after Rocky IV.
Well, he was lucky to get this fucking role. So, count your blessings and actually try.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Yeah, I don't think he's in much anymore.
Who?
Dolph Lundgren.
Hey, he just had Kindergarten Cop 2.
Was that a smash
hit? It went straight to DVD.
Exactly.
Besides the Expendable films, no. He really hasn't done anything. So. But, no, I think we can go into our...
reviews.
Our reviews. And since this was Drew's pick, he is welcome to go first.
I, like you guys, had never seen this before. I just picked it just because I was a He-Man fan growing up, and I thought it'd be interesting to see this. I've always heard bad things, so I figured why not bring it to our giving up of good movies for Lent. There's not a lot here, but I feel like not a lot of people watch He-Man or did watch it growing up. I mean, unless you're, you know, a child product of, like, the 80s, you're really not knowing who He-Man is. Dolph is not great. He looks the part, but his acting is just terrible. Really, the only reason I would stick around and watch this is for Frank Langella. Like, that dude was acting circles around everybody. Like, he actually gave a shit. He really got into the role of Skeletor, which is actually quite entertaining to see. The other characters are just kind of passable, I guess. They're just there. They're along for the ride. The plot, it feels like a long movie.
Mm-hmm.
I think like an hour and 45 minutes. It just feels long. Like, it's drawn out. They go to Earth. It's all this bullshit.
Hell, they go to Earth, what, within the first 15 minutes of the film?
Yeah, it's just, I don't know. It just feels, like, long and drawn out, and, you know, you're just kind of waiting for that inevitable battle between He-Man and Skeletor. I mean, I was waiting for the entire movie, I know. But, nah, I'd just say watch it for Frank Langella. If you're a He-Man fan, this might be worth a watch for you, but if not, you're probably not going to get much out of it. Some of the action scenes were kind of cool, I guess, but that's kind of stretching it. I'd give it a 5, if that.
I'm Ron Burgundy?
Yeah.
It does feel long. It feels like a really long movie. There's a lot of dicking around.
Yep.
Just a lot of doing nothing. A lot of talking about false measurements. I told you should have hired your fictional store where you can get a hammock of jelly.
Quick aside, Con. All the fucking measurement talks in this.
What was the... It's not parsec. What's the other one they kept throwing out?
Preton?
Preton. And
there were a couple others, and it was like, what the fuck are these measurements?
They said it almost as much as Gwildor or whatever his fuck it... Is it Gwildor?
Yeah, you got it right.
Yes!
It only took you an hour.
But, now I'm sad that I know his name. I'll forget it. But,
look up Gwildor porn.
No.
I don't think you want me to. But, yeah, it's not a super entertaining movie, to be honest. Like Drew said, watch it for Frank Langella. And honestly, you could probably just look it up on YouTube to get all of his scenes and call it good, because there's not a lot else going on, unless you're like me and you have a weird attraction to Evelyn for some reason. Because, I don't know, there's just a lot of fucking around. There's a lot of going to houses and looking for shit and asking what shit is. And it's one of those type of movies.
It's like a lot of chasing back and forth.
Yeah. It's slow. The pacing isn't great. But, yeah, if you're a He-Man fan, maybe check it out if you want to get your soul crushed. Are you showing me?
I was just joking around, so.
Alright. But, wow, the train has been derailed. I was going to say, if you're a Courtney Cox fan and you want to see a young Courtney Cox, I wouldn't even bother because she's not even really in it all that much and she's not really doing all that much. Yeah, there's just not a lot of shit here, but it's way better than Yoga Hosers. So I'd probably give it a 5.7.
Yeah, Frank Langella. As Skeletor, even behind that hideous makeup mask or whatever, he hits it out of the park. He said he loved this role, and it shows. Unfortunately, no one else really cared about their role in this film. Yeah, Courtney Cox, barely there. Dolph Lundgren's horrible. I'm glad we threw on subtitles so I knew I was understanding what he was saying. Mm-hmm. Not that he was always horrible, but it helped. Yeah, and just the whole coming to Earth aspect. I mean, you've seen it done. Like, Thor did it.
To death.
Yeah. Howard the Duck did it. Sometimes it's done well, other times it's just, like, is this necessary? And I think you could have done something good in Eternia. I don't know why they had to come to Earth, but just how they set stuff up. Bad dialogue, just bad writing. I don't even know if most He-Man fans would enjoy this film.
They don't.
I was gonna say, I mean, that's like me saying I love the Ghost Rider films. That's not right.
Hey, the first 20 minutes of 2 were straight fire. And then it fucking
went to fire.
Yeah.
But, yeah, this film is just, it's not very entertaining. It's bad. And it's dumb. And it's 80s bad and dumb. I'd rather watch Mannequin. Actually, I love Mannequin. So, I mean, that's like a bad example. I just thought of it because it was a canon film. Yeah, this studio deserved to go under.
Wow.
How can you say that with the Quest for Peace on its resume?
I love Mannequin, but fuck that studio.
Yeah, pretty much. Hey, they tried making a sequel and it was a dog shit sequel, so.
Oh, so they actually made it.
Yeah. I don't know if they... I didn't see it on here. Somebody did, though. Somebody made Mannequin 2, and it was bad.
Distill King Control?
No.
I'm like, why is this mannequin all wrinkled and gross?
The only person who came back was the assistant, his assistant from the first film. Everything else was different. Anyways, that's Mannequin 2. Do not watch that. And I wouldn't recommend Masters of the Universe either. I give it a 4.5.
Wow. Can we all agree that if they would have stayed and not gone to Earth, it probably would have been more entertaining?
Yes, absolutely.
Because then, you know what? You probably don't have Gwildor. No.
Oh, Gwildor.
Gwildor. Whatever his fucking name is.
See, he doesn't matter. No. Like, nobody can remember his name.
He wouldn't have been as prominent in this film because they wouldn't have needed a teleportation piece of shit thing and him souping up a fucking Buick or whatever and Cadillac.
They needed him to get the force field down to get back Sorceress.
Whatever.
Come on, Ty.
Actually upset.
It's so dumb.
I have heard there are talks in the works of possibly doing a reboot.
Are they gonna put The Rock in that too?
Probably. I don't know, but dude,
fuck The Rock.
I like The Rock.
I'm sure he's a nice guy, but Jesus Christ, Hollywood is fucking throwing him in everything.
Because he makes money. No, it's not a true sequel, but it takes place after the original.
Don't care.
But no, he makes money.
I understand.
Yeah. I mean, Tom Cruise used to do the same exact thing. Leonardo DiCaprio does the same.
I don't think he has that likability.
I do, but that's me.
And I don't even hate him. I'm just tired of seeing him.
That's understandable. That was me and, that's me and Melissa McCarthy.
Yeah.
Well, I think going back on the rebooting all these franchises and shit, I think a lot of these movie companies are trying to piggyback on that now, and this is one of those franchises that, you know, people haven't really seen in a long time and kind of want it to be brought back to the forefront again, so...
I think what's so upsetting now is all the shit they're rebooting is shit from our childhood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Whereas before, it was like when Dawn of the Dead came out, the Zack Snyder one, mm-hmm. I remember people being actually pissed off. Like, why the fuck would they do that? And they're like, it took a lot of the social aspect, like the themes, like philosophical type shit, mm-hmm. out of the movie and turned it into a straight-up action movie. But the thing is, I don't hate that remake. No. I think it's good at being an action movie, but I would agree it took a lot of, you know, a lot of what Dawn of the Dead was and kind of threw it out the window and mm-hmm. didn't really understand it. So part of me is like, fuck reboots. I hate them completely. But there's another part of me that's like, you can kind of do it right, or you can kind of do it in your own way, and it's not a travesty, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But outside of that Dawn of the Dead, I can't really think of a remake that I was like, yeah, I actually enjoyed it. Can you?
Well, I was going to say, like, before they knew that they were going to merge them, X-Men First Class stood as a good reboot of the series.
Yeah, it was a good reboot. But I mean, like, remake.
Oh, a remake.
Like Point Break.
Doctor Strange.
Was there a Doctor Strange before?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there was also a Captain America before, and that thing was a piece of shit. Yep.
Or... Fantastic.
No. Shut your fucking mouth.
Yeah, I can't say that.
The Incredible Hulk over Hulk.
I didn't hate Hulk. Hmm. Nick Nolte as Abomination is the best cast. Like...
Because he is an abomination.
He's a drunken lunatic in that movie. He's growling and shit in a warehouse, and I'm like, that dude's the Abomination. Like, it was perfect. I don't hate it. And then Eric Bana's like, yeah, whatever. But Nick Nolte sold that. But it was just me, apparently, because everyone else is like, you're a fucking idiot if you enjoy this movie. So, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know what... Yeah, I'm trying to think of... You'd have to name other remakes for me to be able to be like, yeah, or no. So, I mean, sure. Like, I could name a few songs where I thought the remake was better. Like, Alien Ant Farm Smooth Criminal is better than Michael Jackson's.
I'm thinking this new It movie might be better than the miniseries.
Dude, I'm not gonna lie.
It doesn't take much. There was terrible-ass acting in that, except for Tim Curry.
Yeah, but Tim Curry was such a big part of it, though, that I think, like, not having Tim Curry...
could hurt it.
Well, I think that's what makes a lot of people apprehensive about it. Like, how could you do that? But then in reality, it's like, dude, the show wasn't that great. Like, the miniseries was not that good. Tim Curry was great.
Mm-hmm.
But, I don't know, the trailer looks very promising.
What about all those Robin Hoods? Like, you had the Errol Flynn Robin Hood, then you had the Disney Robin Hood, then you had the Kevin Costner Robin Hood, then you had the Russell Crowe Robin Hood.
Scarface?
Remake? Yeah. Yeah, that is a remake.
I forgot that.
Yeah, that's a good movie. Alright.
Yeah. I was gonna say, I don't know how many, like, I mean, Ghostbusters, obviously, and they say it's not a remake, it's like a reimagining.
I mean, there are examples, mm-hmm. but I think it's really up to the director and the casting just to pull everything together. It's a collaborative effort.
And also, you have Four Brothers, which was pretty much a remake of The Sons of Katie Elder. But they changed where they were at. They changed the type of brothers they were. They were all adopted instead of actually being the sons, and so on and so forth. Instead of being a Western, it becomes a crime.
Do you not like that movie?
No, I like Four Brothers.
I love that fucking movie.
But I'm just saying, it is pretty much a remake of The Sons of Katie Elder.
That's fair.
But, yeah. So it's also just goes back to your definition of what constitutes a remake or a reboot or... Yeah. Mm-hmm. But anyways, I think that will do it for this week.
Kind of a weird ending.
Yeah. We went into a weird tangent, but yeah.
We were like mid-conversation debate, and then we can't think of movies.
We got The Mummy coming up now. I mean, the Brendan Fraser Mummy was technically a remake.
Oh, if you want a bunch of remakes, I've got them right here. All right,
what do you got? Before we go, what do you got?
Total Recall?
That was not good.
That was crap.
Let me see here. Escape to Witch Mountain?
I didn't see either.
Never saw the original. Daredevil? That was a remake.
Yeah. Which...
That's a very good remake.
But there were two... Well, one
no,
was
the
a
newest
prequel,
one's a piece of shit.
Which was supposedly a prequel, right. But yeah.
Old Boy?
No. I refuse to acknowledge that there's another Old Boy.
The Omen?
It wasn't great.
Colin Firth, right?
Yeah.
The A-Team?
Probably not.
I didn't see
it. I never saw it either.
Taking a Pelham 1, 2, 3?
It's alright.
Judge Dredd?
Oh, Dredd? Dredd's a better movie, but I don't like Dredd with the amount of... Like, that movie gets crazy respect, but I don't...
I enjoyed it, but... Yeah, I'm not clamoring for a sequel, but I enjoyed it.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory?
Oh, hell no.
Conan the Barbarian?
Oh, gosh, I forgot they did do that.
Jason Momoa, right?
Yeah.
Never saw it.
Pink Panther?
No, yeah, Steve Martin is not Peter Sellers.
Magnificent Seven.
It's not bad.
I wanted to see it. I never saw the original, though.
I enjoyed it. It's Antoine Fuqua, the guy that did Training Day. I think he did pretty well.
Psycho?
Nope.
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 You didn't like Anne Heche in Psycho?
Nope.
Or Vince Vaughn?
Karate Kid?
Nope.
I didn't think the remake was terrible. It doesn't stand to the original, but it wasn't terrible.
I never saw it, to be honest. I was just saying nope.
Let the Right One In.
Don't know what that is.
It's okay. It's pretty good.
Manchurian Candidate.
Never saw it, actually.
Nope.
Yeah, I mean, they're there.
There are quite a few, so... I'm sure we could think of more, but we don't want to just go down a list of, like, 1,000.
We've lulled the listener to sleep by now.
Yep.
Sleep tight, you princes of Maine.
Maine. Yep.
Okay.
How are you a prince of Maine, by the way?
I don't know. I don't think about it.
Why are you whispering?
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
So I think that'll wrap up this week for Masters of the Universe. Our last week for bad movies for Lent is next week, and it's my pick. And I have a couple thoughts. Maybe Suburban Commando, because I've teased that one before. Or a bad Leslie Nielsen movie that I would still happen to enjoy. You guys probably wouldn't. Or The Comebacks, depending... I know Jake's seen it, depending if I want Drew to see it or not. But...
It's not bad. It's surprisingly funny at points.
But yeah, it'll just be how I'm feeling when that time comes. So we'll see. We'll see.
Actually, it's kind of bad.
It is bad.
Yeah, it's bad.
But it has...
But it has its moments.
Great.
Yeah.
It's a shining endorsement.
Well, the more I thought about it, I'm like, you just said that's a good movie.
Yeah, you're like, wait, I need to back off this immediately. Yeah.
No, it is bad. But it's... I think it'd be the fun bad.
Yes. Especially since we haven't done a spoof movie, so...
We did UHF. What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, UHF...
That's just a shit movie.
Well, I don't put in a spoof keg. It has spoof
stuff
in it.
Yo, it's a spoof movie, dude.
Okay.
When Weird Al is dressed as Sylvester Stallone and Rambo, it's a spoof movie.
Okay, fine. I thought more on the lines of Naked Gun, where they had some spoof stuff in it, but it didn't.
When he's spoofing fucking...
Indiana Jones at the beginning of the movie?
Yeah, or in Beverly Hillbillies, his Dire Straits video, that is a spoof movie.
Okay, fine. All right. I guess it'd just be up to me to do another spoof movie, but... Anyways. Yeah, so like and subscribe. We've had a few people comment recently. We have one film we know we're going to do because of request. So once we finally are back in our normal and the movie is actually available, we will do it.
Yeah. Somebody will pick it.
Yeah. Other than that, you know, we love talking to with anybody who responds or wants to post something. So we're always willing to take requests. We know we're going to try and do good movies now after Lent. I already got mine picked out. So do I.
Yeah, I've already planned a couple out. But I've done that before and then like...
Oh yeah, Contact for the longest time. How'd that ever turn out?
Well, I forgot about that movie.
Yeah. That's because you're back in the annals of TJD Contact. History.
Then it's like week two. I was like, yeah, we'll do Contact.
Then week nine. Yeah, we're going to do Contact.
Yeah. Didn't I officially pick it a couple times? And then yeah, like I would just, hey, so we didn't do Contact.
And then eventually you said, I'm probably never going to do Contact because it's just a good movie. And we'd sit there and be like, yeah, it's a good movie. Okay, see you next week.
I think someday we'll do Contact.
It'll be like a bonus episode.
But no promises.
You're such a fucking tease.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, from all of us at TJD, like, share, subscribe. Libsyn, Twitter, email tjdmoviereviews@gmail.com.
YouTube.
Anything else? YouPorn? Pornhub?
No. Nothing yet.
Okay. Just checking.
Nothing I know of. Unless there's hidden cameras.
Oh, that wouldn't be good.
It would all be Solo stuff.
Han Solo? You dress as Han. You dress as Han Solo.
Jake Solo.
My God. I don't even know what I can say.
So like, getting sued like by and subscribe. Disney.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
All right. That's it from us. I'm Ty.
Jake.
And I'm Drew.